hear ye, the chord of swing is just about ready to do that thing. I don't want no tears, I don't want no lies. Above all, I don't want no alibis. This judge is hip, and that ain't all. He'll give you time if you're big or small. So fall in line, this court is neat. Peace, brother, is Judge Pigmy.
Oh, the judge is high as a Georgia pine today. Everybody gonna do time this morning. Boy, you are exact. You're right.
Yeah, good morning, Judge.
Oh, good morning, you hungry. Good morning, you are hungry. Everybody gonna do time today. Be he man, woman, chick or child, him or her, he or she is going to jail this moment.
Good.
Because the judge is evil this morning. And when I'm evil, boy, everybody gonna do time that day, I'm telling you. What's the first case we got on the docket?
Oh, the first case on the docket this morning, Judge, Your Honor, is a taxi cab driver.
A cab driver?
That's right.
What you got him in jail for?
Why, he's accused of taking advantage of a deaf and dumb girl in his taxi cab.
Yeah?
That's right.
Have you got him in jail?
I sure have.
Bring him in here. I'm gonna give him from now on this morning. All right.
Bailiff, send in the prisoner.
Bailiff, send in the prisoner. Because the judge is evil, low down, and disagreeable, everybody's going to jail today.
Judge, Your Honor, this is my client.
That's your client?
That's right. Judge, you have no objection to my having a word with him prior to the case, do you?
No, talk fast, because he ain't going to be here long anymore.
Look, son, your sister sent me down here to represent you. Now, I think the correct procedure would be for you to explain everything to me exactly as it happened, so that I'll know exactly how to defend you before this judge.
Oh, you my lawyer?
That's right.
Oh, well, I can tell you everything then.
Good.
Yeah. First of all, I want to tell you, I am a cab driver.
I see.
Matter of fact is, I make my living driving cabs.
I see.
Now, I'm driving down 47th Street, and I see a young lady standing on the corner. She's waving, bye-ya, bye-ya. And she pulls me over to the curb, and I picks her up and put in my cab. She taps me on the shoulder, bye-ya, bye-ya, indicating that she wants to go uptown by the way of Garfield Park. I drive down through Garfield Park, and when I come near the exit of Garfield Park, she reaches over, taps me on the shoulder again, bye-ya, bye-ya, indicating she wants to go back uptown. So I proceed to turn around, take her back down through Garfield Park. I drive to 47th Street, let her out on the corner. I get out over the door for her, and she walks away. So quite natural, I run after her to get my money. That's when this old girl comes up, start beating me over the head with her umbrella, talking about I took advantage of her deaf and dumb sister. And I didn't take advantage of her deaf and dumb sister.
No?
No.
What'd you do?
All I did was just roll her. That's all.
Well, now listen. You're going before a very dumb and a very ignorant judge.
Yeah, I can see that.
Now listen. No matter what this judge says to you, I want you to remember this one thing. Whatever he says, you say, Judge, Your Honor, I don't remember.
I don't remember. Yeah, I can remember that.
You remember that?
Yeah, I can
good.
Remember that.
Good. Judge, Your Honor, I'm ready with my case.
Go ahead. I ain't going nowhere. I'm right here. Go ahead.
Judge, Your Honor, take a look at this boy.
Where's the boy?
That's a boy.
That's a boy there?
That's a boy.
When he was a boy, Chicago was a cow pasture.
That's neither here nor there, Judge, Your Honor. This happens to be a fine, upstanding young man.
Yes?
He happens to utilize taxi driving as a means of livelihood for he and his family.
I see.
He happens to have been cruising down South Parkway. A young lady standing on a corner hails his taxi cab.
Yes?
He pulls it to the curb, opens the door, and admits his passenger. She gets into his cab, and she taps him on the shoulder, hollering, bye-ya, bye-ya.
Bye-ya, bye-ya.
Indicating she wanted to ride uptown through Garfield Park.
I see.
Well, my client starts uptown through Garfield Park. Mm-hmm. As he nears the exit,
yes?
This woman taps him on the shoulder again, hollering, bye-ya, bye-ya.
Bye-ya, bye-ya.
Indicating she wants to come back downtown through Garfield Park.
Uh-huh.
My client having no alternative, he takes his taxi cab back down through Garfield Park.
I see.
When he gets to the exit of Garfield Park and pulls into the curb to discharge his passenger, not knowing that this woman was deaf and dumb, she starts to walk away. He starts after her to collect his fare.
Yes.
That is when this woman, claiming to be her sister, which I have my doubts,
she
comes up and starts to beat my client over the head with an umbrella. Had the audacity to call a policeman, have my client arrested, and charged him
with having taken advantage of her baby sister in a taxi cab. Now, Judge, Your Honor, I move that you dismiss this case.
Dismiss the case?
Because it had no business in your court in the first place.
I see.
My client is not guilty.
He's not guilty.
My client is not guilty.
Not guilty. He told you that.
He told me.
And you do believe it.
And I believe it.
I'm going to hear what this dumb gal is going to say for herself. Hey, baby, are you dumb?
No, Judge, Your Honor, I am not dumb.
But who's dumb in the family?
It's my little baby sister.
What happened to her?
Judge, Your Honor, I heard every word that shyster said over there.
Oh, the lawyer?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know you. I'm glad to know who you are. Yeah. Go ahead, daughter.
Well, Judge, Your Honor, you see, it was like this. I sent my poor little deaf and dumb baby sister downtown shopping.
Yes?
She walked to the corner of 47th Street and South Parkway, and she hailed that bum's cab.
Hey, boy, hey, wait a minute now. What are you doing? No, now, don't start that mess in my car. Don't you ball up your fist to hit no more than my car, boy. I'll set the jail on top of you for that. Now, you respect me. You see this black robe and this hat, you know I'm something up here. Go ahead, daughter.
Well, she got in, and she motioned to him that she wanted to go downtown. He drove her through Garfield Park.
Yes.
But do you think he took her shopping?
He didn't.
Why, I should say not.
No.
He rode her up one side of the park and down the other.
Good rest of the life.
In fact, he rode her all over Garfield Park.
All over that park?
Yes, he did.
Ooh-wee! Well, one thing I'll tell you, daughter, she was well rolled, I'll tell you that. What do you think the judge should do to him for that?
Well, you asked me what you should do to him?
I did.
Well, Judge, Your Honor, if I had my way, I'd dig a hole in the ground, put that bum in it, and set the jailhouse on top of
it. I see.
Because he's guilty.
The man is guilty.
He is guilty.
Man guilty.
Judge, Your Honor, I object.
You doing what? Courthouse objecting for her. Every morning, walk in my courthouse and start ejecting. You checked all around behind my judge bench yesterday. Every time I get ready to give somebody some time, you check them out of my courthouse. Hell, somebody got to do time sometime. Look at all these yells I got here. Somebody gonna do them, I'm a doggone if I am.
Judge, Your Honor.
Yeah?
On what grounds you gonna give my client time on?
On the courthouse ground. Ground, I'm gonna get them on the courthouse ground. What ground are you standing on?
Judge, Your Honor.
Yeah?
I feel this thing.
You feel it? I feel a darn knot on your head. You appeal something. You ain't got no right to appeal it up in here. You heard the lady say the man was guilty. I said he's guilty, and he's going to do time. That's what he's going to do. The man.
Wait a minute. I know how to get some justice in here.
Now, wait a minute. Get
away from him. Get away from him.
Hey, boy. Don't shoot me now. Don't do that. What are you shooting the court up about, boy? What's wrong with you? What are you getting excited about?
Excited?
Yeah.
Who's getting excited?
You must be excited shooting up the courthouse like that.
You getting excited? My sister came all the way down here and gave this man the last dime she had in the house.
Yeah.
To try to defend me, and you won't even let him talk.
He can talk all he wants. I ain't had nothing to do with that case.
I know you won't let him talk because I got what my hand
going. You got that pistol? That's what. Hey, take that gun away from me.
I got the gun, Judge Honor.
You got the gun?
I got the gun.
Oh, hold on. You got the gun. It's all right. Are you sure you got it?
I got the gun, Judge.
Yeah, I see it in your hand now.
Right.
Why are you going to raise my stay in the courthouse, boy?
Oh, I'm sorry.
I was going to give you a fair trial. You come in the courthouse and started shooting up the courthouse. You know that ain't right. Come to court and act like a gentleman. That's what you got to do. What's wrong with you?
All I want is some justice.
You got to get justice. You're a citizen, ain't you? So you got to get justice.
Yeah, but I think you're trying to railroad me.
Ain't nobody gonna railroad you. I'm trying to give you a fair trial if you give me a chance.
I know my rights, and I want my rights.
You'll mess around here and get a darn good laugh. That's what you're gonna get. Now you got me so scared, I don't know how much time to give you now.
Judge, you ain't gonna give me no time, is you?
Yeah, you got to do time,
Judge. I don't want to do no time.
You got to do some time. You done broke the law now. Don't start arguing and crying.
Judge, I can't do no time. I done laid in that old jail.
Well, let me look in here and see how much time I can give you. I'm going to give you the smallest amount of time I can give you for the case.
Judge, please don't give me no time.
30 days. That's the best
Judge, Judge, I can't do no 30 days.
You can do 30 days?
I'm a sick man, Judge.
You can do 30 days?
No, Judge, I got cold in my back and knees laying in that jail all night.
And you can't do 30 days? Come on, do 15 days.
No, Judge, please, Judge.
Oh, man, why can't you do some time? I don't understand that people come in my courthouse and I can't give them the time. The justice is in the book, and I'm supposed to give it out like it's supposed to be given out. What's wrong with the guy?
Honey, ain't you Judge Pigmeat?
That's my name. Judge Pigmeat is my name, yeah.
Well, you all remember me.
Well, how come I got to remember you?
I'm Sonny Craver.
Sonny?
Yeah. Man, you went to school together.
Went to school together? Oh, 90 days. I went to reform school. Don't remind
me. Oh, God, no. You got to remember me.
Well, I got to know you, boy.
I am the man who introduced you to your wife.
You introduced me to my wife?
Yeah.
What? Life, you son of a gun. You don't get
it. Gee whiz, I'm so happy. I just don't know what to do. Why, I'm the happiest woman in the world. Why, this is my anniversary, and I've been married 5 years today to the sweetest, to the lovable, to the most handsomest man in the world, sweet Papa Ping.
Mama!
Baby!
Oh, baby, doll, I'm so happy today. The thing today is the day of the happiest day of my life. This is our anniversary.
Yes, it is.
We've been married 5 years today.
Yes, we have.
We haven't had one argument or one quarrel in 5 years.
No, we haven't.
Isn't that remarkable?
No, there's
only... Oh, darling, I got to hug you because I just can't get over it.
But there's only one thing, though.
What's the matter, baby?
We haven't had any children.
Well, I did my part. That's all I know.
My part.
No, you didn't, Mama. No, you
yes,
didn't.
I did.
All you did was live and count the stars, but that's all right there. Yes, so we're happy people together.
Oh, yes, we are.
And I told you I was going to make you proud of me one day, didn't I?
Yes, you did.
You know I'm a big contractor.
I know that.
Built all the biggest bridges in the country.
I know that.
I built the Brooklyn Bridge, the Manhattan Bridge, the Susquehanna Bridge. I got a contract in my pocket to build the biggest bridge ever built in America.
Oh, darling, isn't that wonderful?
Isn't it wonderful? Yes, look at that contract, baby.
Look at that contract.
And with this much money, we can tell a relief to go to hell. We don't need it.
Darling, yeah. Come on, let's go downtown to buy some clothes.
No, we can't go right away. I haven't signed the contract.
Oh, that's
right. I got to go down to the lawyer's office now.
Yeah, I know
and
that.
And I go down, and big lawyers are sitting around a big table. We'll sign this big-time contract. Then I get all this big money, and I can give you all the things in life I've been wanting to give you.
Oh, darling, I'm so happy.
Oh, that'd be nice.
Well, listen, now don't you be going long now.
Oh, now you can't stand for me to go, can you?
No, I can't.
You can't stand me out of your sight.
I can't.
You love me so much, darling. I love you.
And I love you.
You do?
Yes.
Ain't this a darn shame? I tell you what you do, darling. Go home and play the radio. I mean, the radio, whatever it is there.
Yes.
And I'll be right back. And I'll call you every 5 minutes and I'm away.
Now, don't you forget to call
me. While I'm getting
now.
The contract signed.
All right, now, don't you forget now.
Do mama love papa?
Mama love papa.
Papa love the hell out of mama. Let me go.
I'm so glad that old fool is gone. I don't know what to do. Now, I can go out and make love to my sweet papa some miles.
Mama!
Darling!
Oh, baby! I've been waiting to see you.
So long. But listen, Smiles.
What's the matter,
baby?
You
know one thing? I'm so glad that you came by.
Yes?
Because you know what?
Is that old fool gone?
Yes, he's gone.
Yeah.
But you know he's a big contractor.
Oh, yeah.
Uh-huh. Well, he's going downtown to get a contract for a great big job. Now, he's going to make plenty of money.
A whole lot of money?
Yeah,
a whole
lot of money.
Lord, baby, we're going to live it up here.
And listen, you know what? You know those things that you always wanted?
Yeah.
You know that those shoes and that suit and a new hat?
Uh-huh.
I'm going to get them all for you.
Yeah?
Yes,
I am. And you're going to give me that pretty long black Cadillac?
Yes, darling.
Love you to pieces.
Mama, I got the contract signed.
Goodness, my goodness, what's happening?
Mama, what the hell? What are you doing to me? I went down the street 5 minutes, and I come back and find you in another man's arms. Oh, Mama, I'll commit sideways. I can't stand it.
Don't do that.
Now, wait just a moment, young man.
What do you mean, don't stand?
Just a moment. Don't get yourself excited like
why
this.
Why not?
I mean, why commit suicide?
I come back and found you in Mama's arms.
Yeah, but that's no reason to hurt yourself. I've been going with Mama a long time.
Long before me?
Yeah.
Oh, I had second-hand furniture all the time. I didn't know I had it.
Yeah, well, now, wait a moment. Wait, I mean, listen, we're men, you know.
You are, you don't.
Yeah, I mean, we can work this out amiably.
I wish we would.
Yeah, well, listen, I'll tell you what.
Huh?
Now, if you were to give Mama a divorce.
Yes.
I'd marry Mama.
Yeah?
And I'd save your name.
Oh, if I give Mama a divorce, will you marry her?
Why, sure.
And save my name?
I sure will.
You seem to be a nice fella. Shake hands.
I'm a nice man.
Yeah! Now, you got Mama. Mama got you.
Yeah.
Are you satisfied?
Oh, I'm satisfied.
And I'm satisfied.
Yeah.
I'll see you later on.
Oh, just a moment, young man.
What's the matter?
I don't want you to go like this.
I got to go. You got Mama. That's all right.
Yeah, well, I mean, I'd like to give you something.
Oh,
you know,
you want to give me something?
Yeah.
No, give me a dime.
A dime?
That's all Mama's worth now is a dime.
Oh, wait. Just a moment.
Yes, you give me the dime.
Here's your dime.
Oh, boy, I got the dime, and you got Mama.
That's right.
Everybody is satisfied.
That's right.
Well, before I go, it's only one thing I'd like to say.
Yeah?
The breeze may kiss the trees on high,
uh-huh.
And the flowers may kiss the butterfly,
yeah.
And the sparkling wine may kiss the glass,
yes.
And you, my friend, may farewell.
Well, don't pay no attention to him, baby.
Oh,
you know, don't pay him no mind. I'm so glad to be with you, baby.
I am.
Oh,
don't start to holler. I'm going to shot you. I got to shot you.
Oh, mister, don't.
I got to shot you.
Oh, please.
Oh, I'm going to shot you.
Please don't shoot me.
Don't tell me don't shoot you.
Please don't shoot me.
Oh, I'm going to shot this shot out of you. Don't tell me.
Look what you've done.
Sure.
You've killed him.
I know I did.
You do love me.
Yeah.
And you're jealous.
Jealous hell. The boy gave me a Canadian dime. What am I? Touching dirt nowhere.
Man, you floating, ain't you?
Boy, I'm running on the railroad.
On the railroad?
Pullman Porter. Just
huh?
Got in town.
You did? From where?
Los Angeles, California.
Oh, that's a long trip.
Oh, boy, it takes 7 days to go out and come back.
Yeah.
And I'm tired.
Yeah, I bet
just
you are.
Just got in town.
Yeah. that you loaded.
Boy, I'm tired, I'm telling you.
Yeah.
I just got in town this morning.
You did?
Yeah, I went to my house, you know.
Uh-huh.
Got that 7 o'clock.
You did?
Knocked on my door to 9.
Yeah.
And you know something strange that happened in my house?
Yeah, what?
You know my key won't fit in my lock?
The key won't fit in your lock?
No. I don't know what happened.
Well, something's erratically wrong.
Yeah, it fit when I left there.
Yeah?
I stuck it in this morning and jumped back in my hand.
Well, you better take a look into this, man.
You don't go right. I got this very serious about
this. Yeah.
Have you seen my wife?
I ain't seen her.
You ain't seen my wife?
I ain't seen her.
You my next door neighbor.
That's right.
You live right in your next door to me.
That's right.
You can set your kitchen look smack in my bedroom.
That's right.
You looked over there and seen my wife?
I ain't seen her.
That's strange. We are brothers of the same lodge.
Sure are.
You belong to the same lodge I do.
I sure do.
We belong to the Grand United Order of Night Owl.
That's right.
And you're the past exalted ruler of the lodge.
That's right.
If you looked around town and seen my wife?
I ain't seen her.
That's funny. Brother to brother.
Brother to brother.
And man to man.
Man to man.
If you seen my wife?
I ain't seen it.
Hell mercy. I give you the high stress of the sign of the lodge.
That's right.
So I know if you saw, you would have told me that.
I sure would have.
That's strange.
Yeah, well.
So I tell you, I thought about you from out in California.
Oh,
though.
You did?
Yeah.
I'd make you a real brother.
Yeah, you see, I come back and bought this whole suitcase here.
Yeah.
And I've got a whole suitcase full of good liquor.
You got a satchel full of liquor?
Boy, it's good stuff.
I figured,
I know you could do it a dram.
Yeah.
And I figured you would like some.
Yeah.
Look at a big bottle of scotch.
Oh, man, I don't drink no scotch.
You don't drink scotch?
No.
I don't understand you don't drink scotch, man.
I don't like scotch.
Oh, bourbon, you're bourbon.
Oh, man, will you please forget it? I don't drink no bourbon.
And don't drink no bourbon?
No.
I just thought about the thing that happened. The last time I was with you, you were drinking gin.
That gin?
Gin?
Man, you hit the nail on the head.
Drink gin, cause yeah. It ain't no sin.
It sure ain't no sin.
Boy, you like it?
I love that.
Take that bottle of gin in your hand.
Yes.
Did you see my wife?
I ain't seen her.
But go ahead.
Excuse me while I take a drink.
Have a drink. Have a drink. Because you a brother of mine, Lodge, and we are good friends. And we've been friends over a period of years. And you know what I like about you?
What's that, Bigby?
You the man that carried me into the organization.
Well, you know I vouch for you.
I never got into the organization. Don't be for you.
It don't be for me. You don't make it, man.
You don't go right. You walk in the meeting. My application would have been turned down just like that.
Flat.
But you said, go ahead, have another drink.
Well,
have another drink.
Well, I don't mind but do.
Yeah, don't put the stop on. Have another drink. Well, I talk to you because you're a friend of mine and
yes.
A brother of my Lord.
That's right.
And I got all the money I got. I got a whole month's pay in my pocket.
Yeah.
Right now. Got my money this morning.
Yeah.
And he ain't touched yet. Because I said to myself, I'll about beat one of my good old friends.
Yeah.
And my Lord's brothers.
Yeah.
And maybe your rent is due. I don't know.
No,
if it is, I'll take care of it.
Will you take care of my
Lord? Sure, you know I will. Have a drink. Go ahead.
Yeah, I think I will.
Go ahead, drink. I'll talk to you. Before I talk to you. And I said to myself, I said, well, now, my brother is a funny fella.
Yes, sir.
I said, he is a nice fella.
Excuse me, man, play me with.
Yeah.
We decided to take a drink.
Yeah, go ahead, take another drink. I said, my brother's a large brother and a friend of mine, and I don't see why.
Ooh-wee.
Are you feeling good?
Oh, man, I'm mellow as a jello.
That gin is good, ain't it?
Boy, this is the best gin.
That gin come way across the ocean.
Oh, it did.
You can taste the Pacific in that whiskey.
I thought I saw some waves.
Take another drink. God, you a friend of mine, a brother of my lodge, and I know we brothers got to sit down and talk one day about each other's business, you understand?
That's right.
And
that's
I know
right.
You a brother of my lodge,
that's
and I know how you feel about me, because
right.
You know how I feel about you.
Yes, right.
And you feeling good?
I'm feeling great.
Have another drink of liquor. Have another drink of my liquor. You was my friend, a brother of my lodge. Boy, I like you. I always did like you.
I like you too, baby.
You like me?
You're one of my best friends.
That's right.
Yeah.
How you feeling now?
Oh, I'm in a glow.
You're in a glow, huh?
Yeah.
Did you see my wife?
Pig.
Huh?
Pig, you got a dirty one.
Take another drink. I know you know someone. I saw you coming down the street. I know that.
Pigmy.
Yeah?
You know, I'm a real honest, true brother.
I know you are.
And I don't like to see
wine lords and other people's business.
No, you don't bother nobody.
No, of course, that is bad business, especially when it's man and wife.
That's right, you know that.
But she a dirty woman.
Take another drink of my liquor. Drink my liquor and talk to me.
Hey, Meek.
Huh?
Let me tell you something.
Yeah?
Yeah, I can see you right now.
Yeah?
Exactly where she is.
You can tell me where she is now?
Why, sure.
Look, you know where she's at right
why,
now?
No, pig. You know I don't like to stick my nose in.
You don't like to do that. I know you don't.
I like to talk about her.
I know you don't like to talk about her.
But, pig, you're such a good brother.
I know I'm a good brother.
If I was to tell you, you know where the Alice Hotel is.
The Alice Hotel?
Yeah.
You know I know where it's at. Sure.
If you went to the Alice Hotel.
Uh-huh.
Right there is where she is.
Well, who she with? I don't understand who she with.
Oh, man, listen. Yeah. This is gonna break your heart.
No, it ain't gonna break my heart. It's gonna break my head. I know what's gonna happen.
You know Ben Johnson.
Ben Johnson?
Yeah.
Ben Johnson is my best friend.
Well, I got
to take another drink and talk to me.
In a chair.
Ben is my best friend. Ben ain't done me no harm,
is it? Let me tell you something.
Yeah?
Ben Johnson and your wife.
And my wife.
Is right up there at the Alice Hotel.
Sitting in that room in the Alice Hotel? What room is there in?
In room 202.
202? Don't tell me no more. Don't tell me no more. You got all the liquor, because I ain't going to need none where I'm going now. I'm going to jail. I know where I'm going. I know where I'm going. Yeah, you got all the liquor.
You're a good friend.
I know it, and you're a friend of mine.
Yeah, you're my
don't
friend.
Don't worry about nothing, though. You're all right with me, yeah?
I got
everything
it.
Everything is all right. Now, don't fall down.
Don't worry.
Don't fall down. You're all right with me. You are my friend. I'm going to kill my wife if I see her if I don't change my mind. I'm going to kill her. That ain't no way in the world. Oh, look here. Yes, you come here now. Hello, baby. I was talking to
you. Are you speaking to me, or would you like to?
I'm talking to you. Don't start no mess here. Now, what's wrong with you?
Now,
you're my
listen,
wife. Don't
now
start
listen,
that
now, listen, Hot Papa.
Yes?
When I say I'm through, that's final.
What you mean final, baby?
Why, just look at you.
What's wrong with me?
Why, you an old model.
Old model?
Why, I'm looking for new ideas.
How much?
Nothing parks in my garage but brand new cars.
Good rest of the life.
And believe me, I'm sticking pat with plenty of bucks to back up what I'm saying.
Have mercy.
And another thing, Hot Papa.
Yes?
If that collar is a little too tight
yes.
and don't fit,
uh-huh.
then final and crack back.
Don't turn that corner. Don't turn it. Hot Mama, I know you were sticking pat with plenty of bucks, but you got to remember they're mine. I made making down pads on the rattler. I ain't gonna stand to read the sis. See you read them books and bucks out the normal stud. Your cracking is outrageous. If that's the kind of gas that's flowing through your tank, you better change oil. Because Pete Papa's sticking pat with a small engine. Shut up. I ain't shot you. You only saw the pistol. I ain't shot you yet, gal. And I mean it's already fire. And I'll park any old bogus broad in the big moss to try to hand me the double cross. Take mama, and let's go home quiet now.
Cause
I'll kill you. Don't stop
Daddy,
that.
I didn't.
The country.
I do?
Yeah.
Well, that comes natural. I come from out west, boy.
Out west?
Yeah.
Oh, my. You dress different when you dress around our part.
Well, that's only natural.
It is, huh?
Yeah. You see, I come from out in Idaho.
Idaho?
Yeah, I got a big farm out there.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm here on a farmer's convention.
Oh, farmer's convention.
Yeah, I want to give them the highlights on how to grow grilled vegetables.
Oh, you know? I see.
Yeah.
How you like the hotel?
This is a fine-looking hotel you
ain't
got
it a
here.
A fine-looking hotel?
Yes, it is.
Oh, it's 350 rooms in this hotel.
350 rooms?
Yeah, I ain't got
boy, that's a whole lot of rooms.
Oh, man, it's 34 floors in this hotel.
34 floors?
It's a big hotel.
Yeah, we don't grow them that high.
You do, huh?
No, we grow them wide.
Wide?
Yeah.
Oh, boy, y'all must be all right.
Yeah, this is a fine hotel. You know, I hope this convention comes out to my liking.
You do?
Yeah, because I got to teach these boys how to really grow vegetables.
Oh, vegetables.
Yeah, you see, I'm out on my farm.
Uh-huh.
And I got the biggest farm out in Idaho.
In Idaho?
Why, sure.
My,
I tell you what.
Uh-huh.
Just to give you an idea of how we grow things out my way.
Yes.
We grow tomatoes out on my farm.
Uh-huh.
They grow so dead burn big it takes between 11 and 15 men to pick up one tomato and put it on a truck and take it to market.
Oh, Mr. Strange, gentlemen, don't tell me that.
Yep.
You mean to tell me out in Idaho on your farm? You grow tomatoes so big, it takes from 11 to 15 men to put one tomato on a truck to carry to town?
That's right, boy.
Ooh, my, my, my. What makes the tomatoes grow so big out on your farm?
Well, you see, it's the climate, my boy. It's the climate.
Oh, it's the climate. I
see. And to tell you something else, we grow potatoes out there.
Potatoes?
Yeah, you heard about Idaho potatoes, ain't you, boy?
I sure have heard about them.
Well, we grow potatoes out on my farm so dead burn big, you need between 25 and 30 men to pick up one potato and put it on the truck to take it to farm.
Oh, Mr. Strange Gentleman, you mean to tell me out in Idaho on your farm, you grow potatoes so big, it takes me 25 to 30 men to take one potato and load it on the truck to carry it all the way from down?
That's right.
Oh, Mr. Strange Gentleman, why do your potatoes grow so big out on your farm?
Well, it's the climate, my boy. It's the climate.
Oh, the climate.
Yeah. And I tell you something else.
Yeah.
We grow some cabbages out
there. No, now we have cabbages grow here. You know.
Oh, you ain't got nothing but Brussels sprouts here, boy. We grow cabbages out on my farm, so dead burn big.
Uh-huh.
It takes between 40 and 50 men to pick up one cabbage and put it on the truck and take it to town.
You mean to tell me the cabbage on your farm grows so big, it takes from 45 to 50 men to pick up one cabbage and put it on the truck to carry it into town?
That's right, boy.
Ooh, my, my, my. Mr. Strange Gentleman, why do the cabbage grow so big on your farm?
Well, you see, it's the climate, my boy. It's the climate.
Oh, yeah? Well, just for that, I'm gonna give you the best room we got in the hotel.
Oh, yeah.
I'm gonna give you the best room we got in the hotel, but the room is on the 17th floor, and we have no elevator.
Up on the 17th floor and no elevator, boy?
Sure.
How you expect me to get up there?
Hell, you're climbing, my boy.
Hotel.
Oh, man, I just come from down home in Kenosha, Georgia.
Oh, yeah? Oh, you was down in Kenosha, Georgia, huh?
And Georgia's jumping.
Yeah?
Georgia is jumping.
I bet it is.
And I jumped the hell out of Georgia. Hometown a long time.
No, I ain't been home in quite a spell.
No?
No.
You wouldn't know our hometown.
No?
Because everything has changed.
Don't tell me.
You remember the big river was on the west side?
Yeah.
Ain't that no more?
No.
No, they moved it over on the east side. The big tall hill, Johnson's Hill?
Yeah, where I used to shoot marbles?
Got it cut smooth down to the ground, got a big football park there now.
Oh, we playing football at home now.
I tell you, Georgia's jumping.
Man, I'm telling you, that's wonderful.
I went to see a game of football in the park while I was home.
Yeah?
Me and Josh Jones went together.
Oh, Josh Jones?
Yeah.
We went to different schools together.
You remember Josh that
way? Yeah.
I'm talking about old bad hair Josh.
You mean, oh, yeah. Old bad hair Josh.
Yeah, Josh got bad hair?
The worst you ever seen.
Ooh, I told Josh you had mail-carrying hair.
Mail-carrying hair?
Yeah.
What kind of hair is that?
Every nap got its own route.
Oh, Big Meat, you're a mess.
We went to the game together.
Yeah?
Me and Josh.
Uh-huh.
We walked to the gate to buy the ticket.
Yeah.
And a humpback man got between us and the gate.
I see.
And after we stood back, the humpback man walked up and laid down a quarter, bought him a ticket, and walked in to see the game.
I see.
Behind the humpback man, me and Josh walked up, laid down two quarters, bought two tickets, we went to see the game.
Uh-huh.
And
everywhere we went, that humpback man was right behind us.
Doggone.
We went up in the grandstand where we could see the game right good.
Yeah.
Now, humpback man come set right down beside me and my buddy.
What do you know?
The whistle blowed, the boys started to play in the game.
Uh-huh.
The humpback man knowing everybody's playing in the game.
Yeah.
And he started to holler, "Hello, Lou Scott. Yeah. Kick him in the mouth, Joe Davis.
Uh-huh.
Boom, kick off the man's head at the Martin."
Uh-huh.
He raised so much sand, the players got disgusted and couldn't play the game.
What did they do?
Well, the right back told the quarterback to tell the halfback to go up in the grandstand and get that humpback and carry him to the game and give his quarterback.
Oh. Oh, no. Oh, my goodness.
Oh,
they got a real expression.
They
now,
got rid of that humpback man.
Yeah.
And I went to church while I was home.
Oh, no.
Yes, I did.
Don't tell me the church steeple fell down.
No, no. I went to church. Had a lovely time.
Oh, yeah?
Yes, indeed.
You must have been a good boy.
And we got a new preacher there now.
We have?
Yes, indeed.
What's his name?
Reverend Eden from Abidam, Alabama. He's a marvelous preacher, though.
Oh, yeah?
All the Sunday I was there, he walked and talked and hollered all over the pulpit.
Oh, he did?
He looked out his congregation of sisters and brothers. You know, the time is coming when the white horse gonna ride the black horse.
Uh-huh.
And the black horse gonna ride the white horse.
Yeah.
He said, the women gonna rule the world.
Uh-huh.
Women gonna be lawyers, doctors, governors of the United States, and long as the world stand,
uh-huh,
long shall the women live.
Amen.
When he said the ladies gonna live always,
yeah,
a big fat sister in the amen corner got happy.
I see.
She jumped up and shouted, "Preaching, brother."
Uh-huh.
When she jumped up, a $20 bill jumped out of a bosom down in the middle of the aisle.
I see.
The reverend looked down and he spied that $20 bill.
He did.
Come out of his pulpit right down the aisle just to preaching.
Uh-huh.
Sisters and brothers, I said, the time is coming when the white horse gonna ride the black horse and the black horse gonna ride the white horse. He said, the women gonna rule the world.
Uh-huh.
Women gonna be lawyers, doctors, governors of the United States, and long as the world stand,
yeah,
long shall the women live.
Hallelujah.
Just the other one, that $20 bill, he said, stop, sisters and brothers, and everybody kneel in prayer.
Man, Reverend Eaton boy had his eyes on that bread, didn't he?
When everybody kneeled down in prayer,
yeah,
the Reverend was going to pick up the $20 bill.
Uh-huh.
But just as he started to pick the $20 bill up,
yeah,
a one-eyed deacon in the amen corner looked down on him.
I see.
He knew what that deacon told on him. They would turn him out that church. He couldn't preach at that church no more.
That's right.
But he figured a scheme on how to square the one-eyed deacon up.
Uh-huh.
Looked over the one-eyed deacon and said, "He that seeth and knoweth the secret keepeth, and I'll divide later, so says the Lord."
Oh, oh, my goodness. I don't know what I'm going to do with you, Big Meat.
Eatmore could preach more.
Yes, he did a good job.
I'm telling you, he could preach. And you know what? I saw your girlfriend while I was home.
You did?
Lucinda.
Oh, my old gal.
Yeah, Lucinda.
Yeah, she sure was a pretty girl.
She looked good.
Yeah.
Oh, boy, that girl still got that nice shape.
Got a nice figure.
Oh, boy, she's built.
Yeah, she's built.
Oh, she's built like a brick shipyard.
I see. Well, that means she's well put together.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
You know how she's built now?
No, huh?
She got a little bit here.
Yeah.
A little bit more.
Uh-huh.
A little bit less.
Yeah.
All going about your business.
Oh, no. Man, she sure has a hump of femininity.
What? And she gave a birthday party for me.
Well, she's a good-hearted girl.
And everybody in town was there.
Yeah?
Some of your folks was there.
Some of my family?
Yeah.
Yeah?
And they played all kinds of games.
They did.
Played a game called Fair in the Well, Selling the Kisses, Beating Around the Mulberry Bush.
Oh, I know that game.
Which one?
Beating Around the Mulberry Bush.
You played that game?
Man, we played that when I was a kid.
No, you didn't.
Sure did.
How did y'all play it?
Oh, you got yourself a great long stick.
Yeah.
And then you beat around the mulberry.
They don't play like that no more.
No?
No.
How are they playing?
They go right up to the bush.
Oh, no. Man, they kind of shortened that trip, didn't they?
And that game
game called Saturday Kisses.
Hey, that's one I don't know.
Oh, boy, what a beautiful game.
Yeah?
Yeah, Saturday Kisses?
Yeah.
Well, you see, I played that in the kitchen. On all the girls around the age of 17, 18 years of age,
yeah,
it costs $2.75 a piece to kiss them girls.
Man, that's expensive.
It's very expensive.
Yeah.
Because them girls 25 and 26 years of age, uh-huh, it costs $0.75 a piece to kiss them girls.
Man, that's kind of high, too.
Sure. Cost the old maids, they wasn't the 25 cents a dozen.
Oh,
I bought some kisses.
You did?
I didn't have much money.
Uh-huh.
I bought me a quarter worth of them old maids and slobbered all night long. And you know one thing, Chuck?
What?
I like to kiss them old sisters when they ain't got no teeth in front.
Oh, yeah? Why?
Every time I kiss her, I get a gumdrop.
I don't know what I'm gonna do with you, Pigmy.
Oh, boy. And then we played a game called Fairy in the Well.
Hey,
Fairy. And that was a lovely game.
Fairy in the Well.
You never played that game.
No, no, I never played that one.
Fairy in the Well?
No.
Beautiful game.
Yeah?
You see how that game go? All the girls get in one room.
Uh-huh.
All the boys get into another room.
I see.
The boy got to go over and kiss the girl.
Yes.
And that's Fairy jumping out the well. If the girl is too ugly for the boy to kiss,
uh-huh,
he got to give her a quarter.
Wait a minute, Piggy.
Yeah.
Let me get this straight.
Yeah.
You say all the boys get into one room.
Yes.
Then all the girls get into another room.
That's right.
Now the boy has to go over and kiss the girl.
Uh-huh.
That's Fairy jumping out of the well.
That's what they call it.
Now, if the girl is too ugly for the boy to kiss,
yeah,
he has to give her a quarter.
Got to give her a quarter, sure. You know that.
Wait a minute, Piggy.
Uh-huh.
Suppose this cat goes over to kiss this chick.
Yeah.
And she happens to be one of them long, tall,
bow-legged,
knock-kneed,
long
hair.
How about that long?
Yeah.
About an inch long?
Yeah. Ain't no teeth.
Ain't no teeth in the hair.
You mean tell me he's got to give her a quarter?
Sure. And your sister was there. She made $9.75.